out because I used the lecture hall quite often and always did not use a microphone, and also I think people in the back understood. So we had already discussed some time ago that we may have a scientific symposium this fall in November, because it's this year Fred's 75th birthday. It was on 1st of June, and then it's 40 years that he came to Munich and started semiconductor. So this was the beginning. We had already discussed this, and then we decided we anyway make this symposium now as a scientific symposium, but now in memory of Fred Koch.
So now it's maybe slow down with my voice. How to talk about 40 years of semiconductor physics at TUM, and actually I also want to acknowledge, let's say, our main sponsors for this event, it's NIM and ESFG, how we finance also this event. Now, 40 years of semiconductor physics, I have a short CV, scientific CV of Fred. So Fred started studying physics and mathematics at the State University of New York and got a PhD with Kip in Berkeley. And then he went as a professor to the University of Maryland. And in 72, he accepted his full professorship at TUM in the winter semester. So it's exactly 40 years now when he arrived here in Munich. And he retired in 2005, and since 2006 he is Emeritus of Excellence at the TU Munich. Now, before he moved to semiconductor physics, Fred was a metal physicist. So he was studying, let's say, Fermi surfaces in metals, and he became famous because in a parallel magnetic field, electrons are bound to a surface in a metal, and he studied things like copper, tin, and bismuth, and became famous because of this magnetic field-induced surface states in bismuth. So these are two publications which I selected before he came to Munich. This one in the 60s, magnetic field-induced surface states in bismuth, and then in 72 with Ryan Dosima in copper, very similar things. So electrons are bound at the surface of a metal if you apply a parallel magnetic field, because the electrons, when the metal is polished, makes specular reflection, and they make skipping orbits. And this is very similar for a classical system, and this is